Tomorrow the bio invites you to take a look at some of the inventions that we deemed impossible only a few decades ago. As Nelson Mandela said, it always seemed impossible until it's done. That's why the idea of so many inventors and visionaries are received with scorn at first. Invention number one, airplanes. Although flying always has been a dream for humankind, there was a period of time where it only existed through sketches in notebooks and failed prototypes. But everything changed in 1903 when Wilbur and Orville Wright successfully flew an airplane for the first time in history. Before that fateful day, after many unsuccessful attempts of building a functional airplane, the Wright brothers were skeptical about their goals. Everyone believed it was impossible. Can you believe that Wilbur Wright once even said, "Man will not fly for 50 years?" Luckily, he proved himself wrong just 2 years later. Even after the Wright brothers' successful airplane invention, Ferdinand Foch, a French military expert, declared that airplanes are interesting scientific toys, but they are of no military value. Ironically, airplanes soon became a key element in military activity. They were originally used in the First War as a reconnaissance unit, and later, in the Second World War, as an essential part of military strategy. Today, airplanes are responsible for speeding up the way we travel and how we transport goods. Invention number two, Edison's light bulb. Electricity has been invented a few years prior, but it was inventor Thomas Edison who made a serial production and the use of electricity in everyday life possible in 1879. Incandescent, electric light was born because of his invention. The world can now be illuminated at the flick of a switch. However, when he first disclosed his idea for harnessing electricity into light, he faced harsh backlash. It seemed impossible. Edison first illuminated the Avenue de l'Opera and the Place de l'Opera with electric light at the 1878 World Exhibition in Paris. Oxford professor Erasmus Wilson reacted to the event, commenting that when the Paris World Fair is over, the electric light will go out and we'll never hear about it again. When Edison applied for a patent for his version of the light bulb in the USA at the end of 1879, there was a publication in the newspaper that said, "Anyone who's familiar with it will recognize that Mr. Edison's light bulb is a clear failure," a quote by Henry Morton, a scientist and then president of the Stevens Institute of Technology. Many people would hear that the feedback and get discouraged, but not Edison. Instead, he went through thousands of prototypes until he found a way of creating the first viable light bulb. If he would have given up, who knows when, if ever, the world would have been introduced to light. Luckily, public backlash and thousands of failed attempts didn't stop Edison from pushing forward. Eventually, he found Edison Electric Company, which developed into the American multinational cooperation known today as General Electric. Invention number three, heart surgery. Our next pioneer who made the impossible possible is the German surgeon Ludwig Rinn. On September 9th, 1896, a patient was brought into the hospital with a knife wound in his heart. Back in the 19th century, this was considered fatal, and most doctors would have given up on the case. He challenged what was then impossible. A book published by renowned British surgeon Stephen Paget earlier that same year read, "No new method and no new discovery can overcome the natural difficulties that attend a wound of the heart." But Rand believed it could be done and started operating on this patient's heart. Not only did he succeed in saving the man's life, he also savored his bragging rights at a large medical convention the following April, where he first publicly announced his successful operation with his patients in attendance and in prime condition. That same month, a second successful cardiac surgery was performed by Italian surgeon Antonio Parosiani using Rand's published procedure, and many more followed. Invention number four, personal computers. Scientists like Alan Turing, Conrad Seuss, and George Stiblitz made significant progress in building the foundation for modern computing. The Turing machine, built by Alan Turing and his team, helped decipher secret messages within the Nazi regime during the Second World War. Yet in 1949, physicist, mathematician, inventor, and computer scientist John von Neumann didn't see a future for computation. "It would appear that we have reached the limits of what's possible to achieve with computer technology," he said. A lot of people believed it was impossible. He wasn't alone. In 1977, MIT engineer and digital equipment cooperation co-founder Ken Olsen famously said, "There is no reason for any individual to have a computer in his home." In 1977, Apple launched the first commercially produced personal computer. Nowadays, personal computers can be found everywhere and are an integral part of our everyday life. It is estimated that close to 50% of the world's population have access to a computer in their private home. Invention number 5, space travel. It is impossible to know when humanity started to dream about traveling into space, but it wasn't until relatively recently that the first man boarded into the spacecraft Sputnik 1 and became the first person to orbit the Earth. In April of 1961, the Soviet cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin was the first man sent into space and confirmed to all that the Earth was indeed blue. However, the scientific community still could not see space exploration as a viable reality. Absolutely impossible. In 1936, the reputable newspaper The New York Times analyzed the likelihood of space travel, concluding that a rocket will never be able to leave the Earth's atmosphere. Not only were rockets able to travel beyond the Earth's atmosphere, but also humans could travel further away. In 1969, Neil Armstrong was the first man to land on the moon, and space travel continues to develop today. It's difficult to know what humanity will be able to achieve even in a few years from now. We at Tomorrow Bio believe that with the help of science, research and technology, we will one day be advanced enough to revive and revitalize cryopreserved people. At Tomorrow Bio, we are constantly evolving so we are able to offer you the most advanced techniques in cryopreservation. What do you think? Are you with us? We invite you to visit tomorrow.bio and make up your own mind about biostasis. Feel free to discuss your point of view in the comments below and go to tomorrow.bio to get more information about cryopreservation. See you tomorrow.